6-7 Volumes of Cylinders. We're going to start off with this cylinder here. You can see it has got a radius of 8 centimeters and a height of 10 centimeters. And we have worked with the volume before, only in the past we did prisms. And what was a formula that we used to find the volume of a prism? It was volume equaled base area times height. That is the same formula that we're going to end up using today in searching out the volume of a cylinder. The only difference here is that previously our base area was a polygon. Now our base area is a circle. Since our base area is a circle, we're going to use the area of a circle formula. So it's area is equal to pi times radius squared. Therefore, our base area is also going to be equal to pi times radius squared. Plug in what you know that pi is 3.14. You know your radius is 8 centimeters, and of course that's going to go into parentheses because you're squaring the entire thing that the radius is, both the 8 and the centimeters, giving you 64 centimeters squared. Multiply that times your 3.14 and you get 20 and 9600 centimeters squared for your final answer. For your base area. This is not a final answer, that's just the area of the circular base. Now we're going to take that value, which you see listed right here, and we're going to plug it into the base area, the volume formula. So we're going to say the base area is 29600 centimeters squared times the height of the cylinder right there, which is 10 centimeters. Multiply that out, you get 2009 6/10 centimeter squared times centimeter is centimeter cubed. Circle your answer. That is really all there is to these things. They're very easy. You take and pause the recording for a minute and try that one on your own. Alright, for this one, we're still using the same base area formula. Base area equals pi times radius squared to start off, only now the cylinder is laid on its side. Excuse me. The bases are still circles. So we still have circular bases going on, and they give us this time, instead of a radius, they give us a diameter. Since the diameter is 6 inches, we need to acknowledge that the radius is only going to be 3 inches. 3 inches, of course, goes in parentheses. We're going to square everything that the 3 inches are. And in doing that, that's going to give us 9 square inches. Multiply that times the 3.14, and we get a base area of 28 26/100 inches squared. But we're not done yet. We've made a good start, but we have more that we need to do. All we found so far is the area of the circle. Now we need to go a little further to find the height, to multiply it times the height of the cylinder in order to find the volume of the cylinder. So for that, volume equals base area times height, volume equals 28 26/100 inches squared times 12 inches gave us 339 12/100 inches cubed. It's really that simple. That's all there is to doing these problems. Alright, you pause the recording again and solve the volume of this cylinder. For this one, our radius is 7 meters. That's what goes in our parentheses. When you square it, you get 49 square meters. You multiply that times your 3.14 and you get 153 86/100 meters squared. But remember, that's just the base area. We have to find the volume. The volume formula is volume equals base area times height. So we're going to take that 153 86/100 meters squared, multiply it times a height of 14 meters, And when you do, you get 2,154.04 meters cubed. That's all there is to it. Your opportunity to expand your mind with this lesson is page 525, numbers 3 through 23. That is an old book worksheet available on the class website. Yeah.